reporters in the field that we want to check in with. Hurricane Idalia grows stronger with landfall intensity increasing. Right now, Idalia is a Category 1 hurricane, but it's expected to undergo rapid intensification and become extremely dangerous later in the day, into the night, and into the early morning hours. Thank you so much for staying with us. I'm Amanda Hall alongside Chris Safati here this afternoon.
Yep, Idalia is expected to bring storm surge to Charlotte County, as they've been talking about. Wink News reporter Claire Galt live for us on Minnesota Key now. We're going to check conditions around the area. Claire, what are things like where you are?
Chris, Amanda, in the last 15 minutes, things have really picked up. We're seeing a lot of heavy rain that we didn't see in the past hour, a lot of wind. I want you to look over here at these waves. You can see they are very choppy. The tide is really high. It's really coming in. Despite that, I don't know if we move the camera to the right just a little bit, you can see there are still people out there in the water right now. Probably not the best idea, but as I mentioned, just about 15 minutes ago, things were completely different, very clear. Here where I'm standing under this cabana, there are a group of people huddling together for support, watching this storm out. I've got Doug and Doug here, no relation to each other. They just met each other. Doug.
Yes.
Doug.
Okay.
How are you doing here today? Why did you come here to watch the storm?
Well, I come down to Englewood Beach every day regardless. I've been through many storms. The last storm, we lost our basketball courts and everything else. The county put it all back. So hopefully this storm is not going to bring as much wind as the last one did, because Ian was devastating for the whole state. So maybe we'll get a little bit of a break this time with the weather. Just maybe we might see some flooding. I don't know.
Yeah. And Doug as well, how are you feeling? What brought you here today to spend time with your neighbors?
Well, that's what Englewood's all about, spend time with the community. But I'm the executive director at the Englewood Chamber of Commerce, so I'm just going out seeing what firsthand experiences. And like he said, you know, Ian was pretty bad for our community. We're hoping that this storm won't be as bad, but, you know, we're still monitoring it and staying safe and being prepared.
Yeah. How long do you think you guys are going to stay out here today? Are you going to stay until it gets too bad? You need to go inside, or are you just...
Probably not much longer. You know, I think the storm is coming, you know, probably only a couple hours away, actually. I don't know. But it's starting to intensify, so probably after this interview, be heading out of here.
Yeah, I agree. You know, we learned a lot during Hurricane Ian. You know, don't mess with Mother Nature. And so we're just here now seeing what's going on and informing the community, but not going to be out here much longer.
All right. Thank you both so much. You heard Doug and Doug. They're going to get out of here, probably go get somewhere safe. I've been talking to people all day. They told me, yes, they're not that worried right now, but obviously after last year, after what we know, they are taking those precautions, whether it's boarding up their homes, whether it's, you know, getting their non-perishable. Staying inside, probably not coming to the beach is a smart move right now. Amanda, Chris.
All right, Claire, thank you.